I am Mayor Lovely Warren, and it is Black History Month, an opportunity for all of us to celebrate the extraordinary achievements and accomplishments of Black pioneers. But often we forget that many of these amazing heroes are still alive and with us today. Ibtihaj Muhammad, author of The Proudest Blue, is one of those amazing pioneers who has overcome adversity and embraces the truest potential. We are proud to feature her book for Black History Month. I want to take a moment to thank Save Rochester for their work to address the needs of families by helping to fight poverty and feed hungry children. Literacy is one of the most critical challenges facing Americans living in poverty today. Too many of our children grow up without reading on grade level, and some of them never reach their fullest potential. We must do our part to help all of our children succeed so that they can live to their truest and fullest potential. So thank you for joining us today, and let's get ready to read this book, The Proudest Blue, by Ibtihaj Muhammad. Mama holds out the pink. Mama loves pink, but Asaya shakes her head. I know why. Behind the counter is the brightest blue, the color of the ocean. If you squint your eyes and pretend there's no line between the water and the sky. It's the first day hijab. Asaya knows it. I know it. We're sisters. The next day, I wait. A new backpack, new light-up shoes. I feel special. I feel like twirling. Asaya comes out of the house, and I stop. It's the most beautiful first day of school ever. I'm walking with a princess, so I pretend I'm one too. But even princesses have to stop to cross the street. Don't forget, when you're crossing the street, look both ways. Asaya takes my hand in hers, says, come on, Fazaya. We speed walk it. 14 steps, 14 light ups to get across. Asaya takes me to my line first, hugs me goodbye. I turn to watch her leave, give a little curtsy to the princess going to the sixth grade area. She's easy to see. Her hijab smiles at me the whole way. My first day hijab is going to be blue too. What's that on your sister's head? The girl in front of me whispers. A scarf, I whisper back. I don't know why a whisper came out. I try again, louder now. A scarf, hijab. Oh, she whispers. Hasaya's hijab isn't a whisper. Hasaya's hijab is like the sky on a sunny day. The sky isn't a whisper. It's always there, special and regular. The first day of wearing hijab is important, Mama has said. It means being strong. I turn, but I can't see blue anymore. I run to the big kid side. 27 steps to see Asaya. I need to give her another hug. I need to see her smile. Fazaya, Asaya's eyes, wonder why I'm here. Are you excited, I ask, about the first day of hijab? She nods, smiling big, and I feel better. Someone laughs from nearby, a boy pointing at Asaya. Why? Hasaya's hijab isn't a laugh. Hasaya's hijab is like the ocean waving to the sky. It's always there, strong and friendly. Some people won't understand your hijab, Mama had said. But if you understand who you are, one day they will too. In class, I draw a picture. Two princesses in hijab having a picnic on an island where the ocean meets the sky. The girl who whispered in line says she likes it. She says it so loud, the teacher comes over to see it. I wonder if Asaya drew a picture too. Recess time is for 5 cartwheels in a row. I land the last one near the 6th graders, near Asaya and her friends, near a boy yelling, "I'm going to pull that tablecloth off your head." Asaya's hijab isn't a tablecloth. Asaya's hijab is blue. Only blue. Asaya turns away. Her friends turn away. They race to the middle of the schoolyard, their shoes pounding the pavement, playing tag, Mama said. Don't carry around the hurtful words that others say. Drop them. They are not yours to keep. They belong only to those who said them. It's very important words from Mama. It takes me 48 steps to get away from the yelling boy. After school, I look around. I look for whispers, laughs, and shouts. But I only see Asaya waiting for me like it's a regular day. She's smiling, strong. We cross the road hand in hand. I can't wait to get home to show Mama the picture I drew, to show Asaya that I'm wearing the same hijab in it. But Asaya's hijab is like the ocean and the sky, no line between them, saying hello with a loud wave, saying I'll always be here, like sisters, like me and Asaya. The end of The Proudest Blue by Ibtihaj Muhammad. Let me tell you a little bit about Ibtihaj. When she was 12, after she hit puberty, she started wearing her hijab every day. Before then, her mother would have her wear hijab on special occasions and to school on days when she didn't have gym. Having my friends, classmates, and teachers see me wearing hijab a few times a week made the transition to wearing it every day easier. Still, and even though my parents did a great job of preparing me spiritually and physically for covering my hair, she faced bullying from her classmates because of the way she showed her faith. She clearly remembers one boy in middle school asking her, "Why are you wearing that tablecloth on your head?" You remember that from the book? Well, that's a true story that happened to her. Finally, after all of that time, she became very comfortable. And she tells this story so that children who look like her could see themselves in a picture book, a story of family, love, and faith, so that they can see two sisters taking pride in hijab and see that the parts of ourselves that might make us appear different are always worth celebrating, so that children of color, Muslims, and those who are both know they aren't alone. And there are many of them out there who share the same experience. Finally, she's very proud. Proud to wear her hijab. It's a testament to her faith and love of Allah. It's a tradition she shares enthusiastically with her mother and sisters. Her hijab is beautiful. To young girls out there reading this story who are in hijab, your hijab is beautiful too. Take care.